Tonight, former Queensland surgeon Jayant Patel has spent his first night free from prison after having three manslaughter convictions overturned in the High Court.
Andrew Blow has been following this story. Andrew, the former surgeon now wants to go back to the United States.
Well, he's actually required to make regular appointments at the police as part of his bail, but you're right, we're hearing that he may seek to vary those conditions so he can be with his family in the US. Now, the High Court ruled that evidence in his trial was prejudicial and irrelevant, and they overturned his 7-year prison sentence. They ordered a retrial, but there's no guarantee that will ever happen.
Patel appeared calm as he left Walston Correctional Centre, driving his lawyer, who successfully fought the charges against him. This was a man who perhaps couldn't believe his own eyes. He spent the night at his lawyer's house. This morning, Aaron Runniger said his client was upbeat.
He was in good spirits. He was still recovering from the decision.
Patel was convicted in 2010 of killing James Phillips, Jerry Kemps and Mervyn Morris during surgery. But the High Court ruled that the prosecutor's decision to change tack late in Patel's 58-day trial rendered evidence tendered earlier irrelevant and found that the prejudicial effect on the jury was never overcome. Patel now wants leave to fly back to his home in the US state of Oregon and might just be allowed. The state's top prosecutor may decide not to pursue another trial, given Patel has already served 2 years and was eligible for parole in 18 months. Retrying the case may be considered too expensive. Taxpayers would also have to pay $40,000 a year in financial support.
We just wait, I suppose.
In any case, another trial may just be too much for the families of Patel's patients to bear.
But I'm worried for the people and their mental health in going through this process again.
Police moved the 62-year-old to a secret location, his immediate future now just as unclear as the circumstances that led to his conviction.
Well, the answers to some of those questions should be known on Friday when prosecutors appear here at the Supreme Court to discuss Patel's future.
Andrew Blow, thank you.